Has the working class turned away from social democracy? In recent decades, social democratic parties in Europe have lost a lot of votes, while extreme right-wing parties have scored big electoral successes. Because the crisis of social democracy coincides with the rise of the radical right, many suppose that there are huge numbers of social democratic voters, particularly among the working class, who are abandoning social democratic parties in favor of the radical right. According to this narrative, it is particularly the male factory workers who are disappointed with social democracy, which they allegedly feel is focusing too much effort on women's equality and the rights of minorities, and whose economic and labor policies are disappointing. Hence, it is said, social democratic parties need to change their stance accordingly. But political scientists have found out this narrative is not true. A study conducted by the Friedrich Ebert Stiftung shows only a very small proportion of the lost social democratic votes went to radical right parties. Also, today's working class looks quite different from what many think. It no longer consists mainly of workers in factories or mines, but also service providers like those in the healthcare, customer service or hospitality sectors. A large portion of the working class is made up of women and increasingly people with immigrant backgrounds. Many of them have open and positive attitudes when it comes to issues like homosexuality or immigration. Radical right parties do hold a certain attraction for this new working class, but only a small portion votes for them. Social democratic parties and center-right parties are still receiving the greatest amount of support from production and service workers. So, who are those people who used to support social democratic parties but don't any longer voting for now? The study shows there isn't any typical direction for the migrating voters. Instead of the social democratic parties, voters are mainly turning toward green, left-wing libertarian and center-right parties. And how can social democratic parties get more voters excited about them again? The scientists are recommending two strategies, which can be combined with one another. The first is to take a clear left stance on issues of redistribution and social investments. The second is openness and forward thinking on topics like immigration, equality and environmental protection. The study shows society is becoming more diverse and there are hardly any classic voter groups. But progressive attitudes are widespread. That's how social democratic parties with convincing candidates and credible, progressive answers to current challenges can continue to win elections.